malaria is the single greatest killer of children on the planet. We're talking about one child every 15 seconds. This is a fundamental force of nature on this planet. Where malaria's prospered, people haven't. They haven't gone through industrial revolutions. They haven't had political advances. They haven't had the opportunities for advanced education. All these things are due to a sick populace. Malaria is a tiny little single-cell parasite. You get it when a female mosquito bites you. You have tremendous fever, cognitive impairment, and a whole slew of other morbidities. People have been working on vaccines for malaria for almost 100 years. Here at Brown, we take a unique approach. We go to these very malarious areas. Each child has more than one infectious mosquito bite per day. Some children get lots of malaria, and some children don't, despite enormous exposure to infected mosquitoes. And here, we try to figure out what antibodies have resistant children made that susceptible children have not made. We've identified new vaccine candidates that have never been described before. It's considered to be the most exciting new vaccine candidate for malaria that's out there. It takes interdisciplinary research to address a problem like malaria. Our team happens to be epidemiology, biostatistics, cell biology, molecular biology, and immunology. That's our team. What that's allowed us to do, start in the field, come back to the lab, go back to the field. And that is a Brown unique perspective. These students carry the burden of the day-to-day operation of this laboratory. They do tremendous work. The real value of these students is not in what they're doing in these lab benches, it's what they're going to do in 5 years and 10 years when they're inspired by this work. We've been ready to test this vaccine in humans for about the last 18 months. It's very difficult to get NIH to pay for that. If we get through a phase one trial with a signal of efficacy, pharma will be very interested. Populations are going to be in conflict as long as they are desperate, and they're going to be desperate as long as they're impoverished, and they're going to be impoverished as long as there's malaria. It is our mandate here at Brown and the Alpert Medical School to carry these vaccine candidates forward. To finally address this culling machine in a significant way would be amongst the greatest scientific achievements of our time.